Really?
Five? What? This is chaos. Okay. We can't. We have to cancel this.
Five, four, three, we got video.
Now it's on video.
Yeah.
You were gonna do audio. All right. We're down here at the Purple. I got a lot of my friends here, and we're gonna do this. Life is just a tire swing party. A son of a sailor, I went out on the sea for adventure, expanding view of the captain and crew like a man just released from indenture. As a dreamer of dreams and a traveling man, I have chopped up many a mile, read dozens of books about heroes and crooks, and I've learned much from both of their styles. Son of a son, son of a son, son of a son of a sailor, son of a gun, load the last ton, one step ahead of the jailer. Everybody not to clap, because when we did these, there was no one here, and I got used to it like that. This is going to be a tough one. Jimmy Buffett was, let me just play a few more. juicy fruit. Wash away the night. Drive in. You guys are young. Commit a bunch of mold sin. Love is good for your soul. Yesterday playing these songs. I love these songs. This, for me, you know, Jimmy was, nobody did more for me in my life than Jimmy. So it's hard to talk about him, you know. I met him through Keith Sykes, but really my first met him was there was a kid down the street named Eddie Hallberg, and whatever he did, I thought was cool. He was like 4 years older than me, and I think I was about 10 when you came home. My brother's here, and told me that Eddie had this guy that had a song about a cheeseburger, and I was gonna love it. And then he got so obsessed, he'd go to all the concerts, keep the set lists, and so when I was real young, me and Eddie Hallberg got so into Jimmy Buffett, and then Tim Ball, my friend, went to see him when we were in eighth grade and saw some of our teachers. We felt so cool. And then I met Keith Sykes, who had been the Coral Reefer. And we were, the day I got a record contract with Capitol Records, and the day it happened, me and Keith were driving down the street, and Jimmy pulled up in the car next to us, and they waved and pulled over and went to lunch. And that was the day I met him. And Keith said, "This is Todd. He just got a record contract." And then I lost that contract. I did two recording sessions and got fired. And it was kind of a funny story. And Jimmy heard it, and Keith sent him some of my songs, and he sent Bob Mercer, who was running his label, and Mike Utley, to see me at this place here in Nashville. And then they came to see me again in Memphis, and then they called Jimmy and said that they wanted to sign me, so he said to fly me out to play the Greek Theater. I opened for him at the Greek Theater. It was the second time I saw him, and he was watching the show, with Clint Black and Joe Walsh. And when I came off, they were standing there, and he said, "Do you want to make a record for me?" I'll never forget that. I still have pictures of that. And then he let me do that and gave me complete artistic freedom, and I poured millions of dollars into me for no good reason. He wasn't trying to make no money. And I met his niece, Mara, who's here today. She flew all the way from New York. And I met his family and the Bob Mercer and Margie Mercer, and so many of my whole family in music. That's why I say I never got screwed over in music, because I came in through the Jimmy Buffett tour. All the people I met were cool. That's the truth. So I'm going to try to reflect on him, you know, and play his songs, and say hello to my friends out there. I know Seamus is in New York working with Leanne Rimes because of Jimmy. Hey, Seamus. Will is playing with Emmy Lou Harris somewhere today. He's watching because of Jimmy. Wrote a bunch of songs with Jimmy. In fact, I think that there's a new record coming out. So I'm just going to get... Make me feel alright. Rocking and rolling on Livingston Saturday night. Pick up the wall, say you just got paid. Any lucky dog, you might even get laid. They be rocking and rolling on Livingston Saturday night. So won't you listen to the sound of the hot country band and the boot heels shuffling on. Saturday night. That might be the way. goes, you know. That might be how that goes. Maybe, you know what, when I was saying don't clap, there's so many people in here. Maybe you should clap. Okay. Feels funny, doesn't it? Yeah. It can feel like, yeah. Usually we do that, it's like four people in here. I'm like, don't clap. But yeah, after the songs maybe say stuff like, eh, you know. Second verse was good. So far though, not bad. I think there's more verses to that, but if there's, sure. You think? Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure. Well, this thing, we'll have to play that again. At the end. God, man. And then, just the shit. My favorite story for me was, there was this big yellow seaplane that Jimmy was thinking about buying. I hadn't known him very long at all. And he asked me if I'd go look at it with him. And I think we were in San Francisco, and it was this big yellow banana-looking thing. And we get in it, and Jimmy's going to fly it. And then the guy says, we can just go to Seattle. Isn't that crazy? And Jimmy took the fucking thing up out of the water in the ocean. Flew it up, landed it in the ocean in Seattle. I couldn't believe it. We were talking about how genius. They call people geniuses all the time for singing. And a lot of time I think they mean music genius, you know what I mean? But like my brother knew Jimmy. He could fly. He could sail a ship. He could tack sail a ship. Guy could surf, good, could golf, fly fish, new languages, just, and did business. Fuck, there wasn't a part of the music business he didn't master. It was a different cat, man, resonating on a different thing. So that's my speech there. I'll be throwing in pearls like that for the rest of the show. This is a song called Boat Drinks, right? We have the teleprompter because I was just trying to figure out the chords and trusting that hopefully I'll know the words. I think I do. Boat drinks, boiling band, old boat drinks. Visitors just scored on the home ring. Everything seems to be wrong. Everything seems to be wrong. Lately, newspaper mentioned cheap airfare. I gotta fly to Saint somewhere. I'm close to bodily harm. I'm close to bodily harm. 20 degrees and the hockey game's on. Nobody cares, they are way too far gone. Singing boat drinks, something to keep us all warm. Something to keep us all warm. Six holes in my freezer. I think I got cabin fever. Somebody sound the alarm. Somebody sound the alarm. I gotta go where the pace of life's slow. Could you be me somewhere, Mr. Scott? Any old place here on earth or in space. You pick the century and I'll pick the spot. Boat drinks. There's a need to know boat drinks. There's a sport on the home ring. I gotta go where it's warm. Oh, I know I should be leaving this time. I got a verse but can't rhyme it. heading south for my dreams. Shrinks, I gotta go where it's warm. I gotta go where it's warm. I gotta go where the pace of life's slow, where there ain't any snow, where there ain't any blow, cause my fence ain't so low. I gotta go where it's warm. I got to go where it's warm. I love that one. Yeah. Man, will you pull that back? Roll that back. This is the best part of this. This is, because I've been having a hard time relaxing. Roll back. Let's just tell everybody what's going on. Is this a new Google thing? So I kind of know this song, but we have the lyrics. So it says, could you beam me somewhere, Mr. Scott? You picked the triplet here on Earth or in space. You picked the century and I'll pick the spot. You also might like to hear from some thug life. Blaze, you also might like thug life. Blaze, your dead homie, alone, twisted, forgot about Dre or Dr. Dre. Here's verse 3. All right. So there might be some like shit like that. But also I noticed I haven't played all year. I took the whole year off, and that thing when I stopped and played guitar, there was a solo that was happening. I just was missing the string. I'm going to do this one. But I hope this is sounding good to you at home. Anybody could just get up here and do shit they knew really good. I know most of these songs like just sort of in my heart, and I knew that I could play them. And as we go, I bet you I start nailing them. Pleasure makes me want to go back again. If it suddenly ended tomorrow, I could somehow adjust to the fall. Good times and riches and son of a bitches, I have seen more than I can recall. It's these changes in attitudes, changes in attitudes, nothing remains quiet. And dream of the ocean, God, I wish I was sailing again. can't go wrong. With these changes in latitudes, changes in attitudes, nothing remains quite the same. With all of our running and all of our cunning, if we couldn't laugh, we would all go insane. If we couldn't laugh, we would all go insane. If we weren't all crazy, we would. Wrote this on their Mars rock. Oh, I don't know. Well, I don't know. I don't know where I'm gonna go when the volcano blows. Well, I don't know. I don't know. I said, I don't know where I'm gonna blow. Volcano blows, all right. Bounce is moving under me. The tidal waves out on the sea. Sulfur smoke up in the sky. Pretty soon we're gonna learn to fly. Said to me, said the man, you'd better watch your feet. The lava come down soft and hot. You better lava me now, while lava me now. I said, I don't know. Said, I don't know. I said, I don't know. No time to count what I'm worth, 'cause I just left the planet Earth. Where I go, I hope there's none. I said not to worry that the monsoon will come. Listen now, I don't know. I don't know. Said I don't know where I'm gonna go when the volcano blows. All right, said I don't know where I'm gonna go when the volcano blows. All right. I suppose if you want to walk down here and join us, oh man, this thing's jacking us up. Well, there's another verse to that. I'm saying there's all that, but I'm just gonna keep playing this shit till I start feeling like I'm nailing it, and. Until this, I feel better. You know, last week, while I was hearing about this, I was up in, Woodstock. Somebody asked me, they paid me to come talk about songwriting to people that paid to hear it. It was, and, I was kind of a teacher or whatever, but it's not like there's a wrong way to make up a song, you know. But I was just sitting around with people that are into it, you know. And there were so many of them were asking me about Jimmy and what he was like. And there was a guy who was a mayor from somewhere. I bet you he's watching too. And we were just all sitting around outside, and he played Tampica Trauma. I don't even know if I could do it. I'd never heard anybody do it. And, so I asked him, should we play that song? I had my glasses on. He couldn't see how. Making me sad, but I was so glad to learn it, and I was just glad I was up there with them cats. I hope I'm making some sense. I'm sure you can tell that I'm bumming. Cincinnati, man. The song is about a girl from Cincinnati. She came down from Cincinnati, took a 3 days on train, looking for some peace and quiet. Hope to see the sun again. And that part of that area of the country, Cincinnati, that was his main place. I opened for him, the biggest show I ever played, 67,000 people. Somewhere near Cincinnati. And I remember when I played, when the songs would get over and everyone would roar, it would tickle your feet. It would make your feet feel asleep. And I thought, man, this guy's doing this every night. And he told me, he said that Cincinnati is the furthest place in America you can get from the ocean. Isn't that weird? The most landlocked place in the United States. And that's his main jam. That's his main jam. They're all main towns for him. Well, let's check this one out. She came down from Cincinnati, took a 3 days on the train. She's looking for some peace and quiet. That's all. She's just hoping to see the sun again. Now she lives down by the ocean. She's taking care of the look for sharks. They hang out in the local bars and they feed right after dark. Can't you see them circling, honey? Can't you see them scooting around? You got fins to the left, fins to the right, and you're the only baby in town. And then he goes, took 3 days on the boat. some peace and quiet. Maybe keep a dream afloat. Now she feels like every morrow, because the blues still was at hand. Just behind the reef of the big white teeth of the sharks that could swim on land. Can't you feel them circling, honey? Can't you feel them schooling around? You got fins to the left, fins to the right, and you're the only bait in town. This one called Ringling. One time I was playing in New Orleans at Jimmy's club, and he came back stage with Hunter Thompson. I couldn't fucking believe it. And he said his name was Hunter. It's my friend Hunter. And then went Hunter Thompson, and he went Hunter Thompson. And then, man, you know, the troubadours that I've met in my life have been so kind to me. And they're all so kind to people that they like, other troubadours, no matter who they are, you know. Man, Jimmy used to let me stay at his house in Key West. Get out of here. And then to talk to, you know, he's like, he's got such luck too. Like when he sold that house, like a week later, did you remember that? It got tornado, took it or something. Like, that's his luck. Or not luck, but. Ringling, ringling. Slipping away. Only 40 people living their day. Cause the streets are dusty and the bank has been torn down. It's a dying little town. A church, a window's broken. That place ain't been used in years. The jail don't have a sheriff or a cell. Electric trains run by maybe once or twice a month. Muscle and all down to muscle cell. It's a dying little town. Oh, Dolly. Let's see, I want to try some, you know what I want to try? There's a My Lovely Lady song Jimmy wrote for Margie. Now, Margie Mercer, I've talked a lot on this show and in my shows and things I do about a guy named Bob Mercer. And Bob was the president of Margaritaville Records. And he was married to Jimmy's first wife, Margie Mercer. And they were each other's, they started dating when they were 15. And they never, you know, they stayed in each other's lives. And I talked to Margie for a long time last night. I know she's watching with Sam. Love you, Marge. And she told me some great stories about Jimmy, you know, like, she even told me this thing last night about how he was writing, and then he started writing songs, and at first he thought he could be a writer, and then at a certain point he started thinking, like, she said at first he didn't really sing, and then he started thinking maybe he could sing. And I thought, that's weird to think of a world where Jimmy Buffett wasn't thinking he was going to sing his own songs yet, you know. That would have been... imagine the world without all that parrot head. That whole guy has a retirement home. I miss having him in the universe, man. I'm gonna try to play this song. I was singing that song thinking how far back that would, you know, go. And it reminded me of this story that I heard from Jimmy and Keith Sykes and Jerry Jeff, which was that Jerry Jeff had made about 4 or 5 records, and he met Jimmy, who had made 2, and they were really close. And Jerry wanted to take a break from it all, and he went down to Key West, and he met this girl, I can't remember her name, but he said that she was what they called a kind-hearted woman, and there was a cat on her fence. And that meant that you could stay there, I guess. Something he knew, some old drifter shit. And Jimmy had gone down to Key West, I think, and met this girl. No, Jerry Jeff had. And he had stayed with this girl. And then he, this Keith's version. So then Keith Sykes made two records, and he was burned out. I think he got dropped. And he was talking to Jerry, and he said, you should go down to Key West and just, you know, reboot or whatever they would have said then, you know. He goes, there's this girl, you got to go find this house and it'll be great. And Keith said, so he goes all the way down there, and there's a guy raking leaves in the yard, and he asks for this girl, and the guy raking goes, you know, who wants to know? He's like, and Keith was like, oh, she might have a boyfriend now or whatever. He said, well, I just, Jerry Jeff Walker said I could come here. And the guy was like, oh, you, Jerry Jeff sent you here? He sent me here too. My name's Jimmy Buffett, you know. And then you should meet my friend Fingers Taylor. And so those three started playing around in, Key West like that. And then that's kind of what I know. Here. If y'all start to get bored, don't feel weird if you gotta take off, because this could go for a while. And for those of you playing along at home, this just feels good. I hope you're home. I hope you got some parrot shit on. I hope you got a lay on. I hope you're drinking margarita. I hope you're high. Sat there on the coast of Marseilles, thoughts come by like a wind through my head. How good it be to hold you, oh, how good it would be to feel that way again. Would you be remembering me? Oh, I ask that question time and again. The answer came and haunted me so. Oh, I didn't want to think it again. I didn't want to think it again. Make it so hard to forget that I hadn't stopped loving you yet when I left the coast of Marseilles. I hadn't done what I'd come to do. I spent all the money that I saved. Oh, I never did get over you. I never did get over you. See if you can find one called Brand New Country Star. Yeah, I'm gonna start playing some shit. That's supposedly what I know. That's the stuff I feel like. There's a bunch more where I got people like Jimmy, John, Jerry Jeff, Shaver, Chris, where I can just kind of play all their songs, you know, at least to the degree that I'm doing it now. Yeah. Oh, I can do this. Practicing. All right, I'm winging it. Well, he outgrew his sequin suit. He sold his trailways bus. Let his hair get a little too long. Duck tails bit the dust. His custom made pearl inlaid guitar slipped from his hand. Hang on, everybody. This is gonna be worth it. This is gonna be worth it. Now we're tributing. I'll try to think of some other fun stories. I remember the one time, even in my book, I talk about the time I got into an argument with him. And now I look back at that as the time he was speaking genius to me. And I didn't understand. But, he hit me and he threw a piece of pineapple at me. I love that memory. What was I going to play? Oh, yeah. What the fuck? His ducktails bit the dust. The cousin gone, his ducktails bit. What's up? I don't know. I don't know about that one, dudes. I thought I knew that. Well, ain't this about the son of a bitch? Standing on the side of a highway 4 exit. Lady in tie-dye with a bag by her side. not seemingly looking for anyone special. She saw my Tennessee tags and she waved for it. She sat back beside me as the meter hit 60, explaining her travels and her family background. When she got through, I could not help but thinking, she's a long way from West Nashville Grand Ballroom girl. Father had money and mother had love, channeled entirely to her dear sister Dove. 22 years in society's plan canceled at the swing of her dear mother's hand. 2 hours later, we hit Cincinnati. Yawning, she woke up and she asked where we were. When she found out, she said, I must be going. She said this close to Nashville was too close for her. So I stopped by the roadside and I gave her $5. She took it and she kissed me and then she gave me a note. She told me I could beat it if I mailed it in Nashville. On old loose leaf paper to her mother she wrote. She said, Mama, I'm fine if you happen to wonder. I don't have much money, but I still get around. I haven't met church in near 36 Sundays. So fuck all those West Nashville Grand Ballroom gowns. Fuck all those West Nashville Grand Ballroom gowns.
My best memories of this one's tough because this is Jimmy Buffett, America, and that was that was a comet like no other. Not just a troubadour either. I mean, that was, he was a king hell troubadour though, man. That fucker. He has a new record coming out. Will Kimbrough, who they're from the same town, so he was in my band, and they sound alike. They're from the same town, and I don't know how many songs they've written since then, like a dozen maybe. They've written together. Will is, so many people are hurting today. A lot of energy, man. That guy. Had a huge family that he took care of, and getting to be part of that machine, that big, huge, it was like being around what, it was kind of like what a Stones tour would probably be like. And all those people, same people, they're all the people that were there 30 years ago had been there 20 years before they met me, and they're all still there today, you know. I can't stop talking about it. This is the day to do it. So I'm going to try this one that he wrote with Jerry Jeff Walker. Well, those two were buddies. Send this out to Susan and Django, who I know are also really hurting today. Spent her whole life on train. Semi-good looker till the fast trail that took her. Trying to get home again. As I was stationed in Boston to the freight yards of Austin, Florida sunshine, the New Orleans rain. taking all the best tracks. She's trying, just trying to get home again. She's a railroad lady, just a little bit shady. Spend the whole life on the train. Semi-good looker, the fast trails that took her. She's trying, just trying to get home again. Once a highball loner thought he could own her. Gave her a fur coat and a big diamond ring. She hocked him for cold cash, left town on the wall back. Never thinking of home way back then. Now the rails are all rusty and the dining car's dusty. Gold-bladed watches have taken their toll. Yeah, the railroad's dying and the lady sits crying. On the bus to Kentucky now and a home that's her goal. She's a railroad lady, just a little bit shady, spending her whole life on the train. A semi-good looker, now the fast trails took her. She's trying, just trying to get home again. On the bus to Kentucky and at home. I'll just do a handful more here. I'm going to do Pencil Thin Mustache, Brian. And, I was going to try God's Own Drunk, maybe. I'm trying to think of some other things about Jimmy that I got to see, or, you know. He's a pretty private person, you know. But just, even if I hadn't known him, I'd be doing this today. I got a long letter from Hayes, too, about how important Jimmy was to him. Bob Dylan said he was one of his favorites. But just for people who are living the Ramblin Jack Elliott life, Jimmy threw a perfect game at that, you know? And it's just a big gap in our... All right, hang on, just let me, I'm gonna fuck this up. Oh, what? Yeah, he stole this shit from me. Flat top, dirty bop, cop in the field. rubbing on the living room floor. So sore, it'll send you off to college to gain a little knowledge. But all you want to do is learn how to score. Now I'm getting old and I don't cut my hair. I don't go to church or wear underwear, but I can go to movies and see it all there, just the way that it used to be. That's why I wish I had a pencil thin mustache, the Boston Blackie kind, a two-toned Ricky Ricardo jacket, and an autographed picture of Andy Devine. I could be anyone I wanted to be, maybe Errol Flynn or the Sheik of Araby. If I only had a pencil thin mustache, I could do some cruising too. God, I love that one. Only had a pencil thin mustache, I could do some cruising too. They said, yeah, real cream, a little dab will do you, or I could do some cruising too. Yeah, Jimmy, man. That's one. Let's see. You know what else? This one's Boss, too. And Margie was telling me that this... He met a woman named Jane down there in Key West, beautiful, and she's who this song is about. I didn't know Jane that well. I mean, but Savannah, we knew Savannah one time for New Year's Eve, my favorite New Year's Eve ever. It was you and your sister and Savannah and the Nervous Rex. And our girlfriends and shit in that house. Oh, your mom. Oh man, to the Buffetts. Yeah. Francisco for Labor Day weekend show. I've got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. Honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. But come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in the brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side. Yes, it's been quite the summer, rental cars and westbound train, and now you're off on vacation. It's something you try to explain. Darling, I didn't know. That's the reason I just had to go. But come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in the brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey. You're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt. I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know it's pretty up there. Hey, we can go hiking on Tuesday. With you, I can walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in the brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in the brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I'll tell you. Living on a sponge cake, watching the sun beam. All of us two red covered with oil. Drumming my six string on my front porch swing. I smell the shrimp there beginning to boil. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost shaker. Some people claim that there's everyone to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I don't know the reason I stayed here all season. Nothing for sure but this brand new tattoo. It's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. I got here, I haven't a clue. Wasted away. Searching for my lost shaker of soul. Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I blew out my flip-flop, stepped on a pop top. I cut my heel at the cruise on back home. But there's booze in the blender, and soon it will render that frozen concoction that helps me hang on. Wasted. Searching for my lost shaker of soul. Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. I'm searching for my lost shaker of soul. Some people claim there's a woman to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. Vegas did they wait again in Margaritaville, searching for my lost shaker of soul. Some people claim that there is a woman to blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. Some people claim that there is a woman to blame. Man, how about that for a jam? Went to number 8, but it's my own damn fault. What a song, just one song. I remember just loving that song when I was a kid. And then it's just a gateway to this universe, you know, that you can go to. Key West, we went down there many times. I still like to go down there. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I would want to play before. I feel like we've been going for a while. All right. I kind of hate letting go. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Yes, I am a pirate, 200 years too late. Cannons don't thunder, there's nothing to plunder. I'm an over 40 victim of fate. Life ain't too late. Life ain't too late. I've done a bit of smuggling, borrowed my share of grass. I made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast. It's never meant to last. Never meant to last. Well, I have been drunk now for over 2 weeks. I passed out and I rallied and I sprung a few leaks. But I got to stop wishing, I got to go fishing. I'm down to rock bottom again, just a few friends. Just a few. I go for younger women. I live with several a while. I run them away. They all come back someday and they still seem to manage a smile. Just takes a while. Just takes a while. Thank you. years I found occupational hazard is occupation, it's just not around. I feel like I've drowned. 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 Man, man. Man, oh man. Gonna miss you, Captain. For coming down here. Well, Sam's over at Margie's, right?
Yes.
Yeah. This my buddy Glenn Rose just came in. I can't see everybody in here, but Glenn took the cover for the second record, right?
Yeah.
And then we went on those tours together and all that. And then you did all the Kenny Ch- I mean, you've just done. Check out Glenn Rose's photography. What a great group of people we have here. And Sean Kay out in California, I want to say hello to. All right, so I'm not going to do that one. I'm going to do a song called Lovely Cruise. You got that? You can put that up. Man, I wish I was feeling more eloquent or whatever today. I'm not shocked, just sad, and a lot of energy, just but it's gonna be good. We're all gonna have fun. Maybe we'll go to Key West next year and do this. That'd be a good idea. This one's for you. It's been a lovely cruise. I'm sorry it's ending. Sad, but it's true. It's been a lovely cruise. These moments we're left with, you always remember. These moments are shared by few. The wind in the water, water in our shoes. It's been a lovely cruise. These moments we're left with, may we always remember. These moments shared by a few. Those harbor lights low, they're coming into view. It's been a lovely cruise. We bid our farewells now too much too soon. It's been a lovely cruise. Drink it up, this one's for you. It's been a lovely cruise. So it's over, so sad, but it's true. It's been a lovely cruise. So drink it up now. This one's for you, Jimmy. It's been a lovely cruise. Well, thanks for indulging me out there. And, you know, hug the people that you love and don't let folk singers tell you what to do. Here's my encore. To leave us on a fun note, I'm going to share with you something I learned from Keith Sykes. This is Bob Dylan singing Margaritaville. You're living on the Spanish Key. Not in the Sunday. All of us till it's covered with home. Strumming my sixth string on my front porch swing. The smell of the shrimp there beginning to blow. Wait till the weekend in Margarita Van. Searching for my lost shaker song. Some people claim they're the horn and the brain. But I know that I love you. Thank you, Jimmy Buffett, for changing the world the way you did.